been double crossed.
Hi, you know whom? Successfully lost. And you know what? I have to ease my soul. I need to rant a little bit. And this time, I have to rant about Baldur's Gate 2.
Yoshimo, how could you? How could you? Exactly, Ari.
I really can't hold this within my soul. I've been double-crossed. I've been double-crossed. And it's shame on me. I haven't been double-crossed just once. I've been double-crossed twice. Twice! Can you imagine? Baldur's Gate 2, Shadows of starts quite energetically, and you are in a place where you no longer wish to be, and everything is horrible, and you meet a man, Yeranicus, who will, you know, be the fil rouge of it all, obviously. I'm not done yet. But I reached a point where I was sincerely hurt. I was truly hurt. I am super, super mad and super, super grateful to the designers of the game for this kind of an input, because it feels really real. It feels super real. I felt so annoyed, so annoyed. I'm hurt, genuinely hurt.
No doubt you are brimming with concern for your Imowyn.
Is that Yeranicus? Because the voice is similar. Well, after meeting the man who will, you know, pave the way through all the chapters, obviously. Well, more or less. I was kind of stuck in chapter 2 for a very long time. And what is really different in Baldur's Gate 2 than Baldur's Gate 1 is the fact that in Baldur's Gate 2, in chapter 2 specifically, there is really no linear story. There is like, you are kind of like a trapped fly in an apartment, and you're like, you're going up, down, left, right, and you're just doing the tasks. And surprisingly, sometimes you start with the ones that I couldn't cope with. I was like, I cannot survive this, like leeches. And then you finally realize that in the end of chapter 2, you go to some of the tasks and you're like, that wasn't that hard, was it? Like, you meet the opponents and you're like, just like, it just blew the candle off, you know, something like that. That's really funny, because you can't predict that, you can't know that. And you kind of just wander around, and then you stumble upon it. Once you get out of chapter 2, then it kind of goes quickly, you know, chapter 3, chapter 4. And suddenly, you are back to the guy who really irritates you. He irritated me really, really, really much. Yeranicus, that is. Once you get to him, I was unfortunate enough to have insisted on having Yoshimo in my party. Don't worry for Yoshimo. Do you want him dead as well? Many people want him dead. That darn Yoshi. He really didn't care. Yoshimo, I trust everything is as I instructed. I told you Yoshimo is a pain in the butt. He had some hidden agenda. I told you about him. I knew it, he was no good. He didn't care about the little party we had. He didn't care about all the people within the party. He didn't care that I'd invested like tons of HP into him and all of the beautiful items we've found. He stabbed me in the back. Completely stabbed me in the back. Like, bluntly then later on stabbed me in the back. All the time I was hoping like, all right. I'll confront him and he'll be sorry and he'll help me out. I'll confront him and he'll be sorry and he'll help me out. No. No. No! He did not. He did not do that, not at all. Yoshimo, you are gonna burn in hell. I was left there to be sent to that bloody maze of bodies. Yes, of course, I aligned with the Shadow Thieves. So I was there to meet this bloody, literally bloody Bodhi, and she was playing like a game on me or something. I hate her as well. Yeah, I hate her. I got out. Can you imagine? But what happened in between? I was shot in the heart second time. Ari left. Fine, I'll go if Lost has a thug like you around, then there is no need for me, is there?
No! She had all of my things! She just she's just freaking asshole! She just vanished in the middle of the place where she should not go anywhere. Bodhi will have her for lunch.
Oh my.
I lost Ari after saving her, after doing her quest, after, I don't know, doing all the things. I constantly defended her when Chad was saying silly stuff about her. She was not that whiny. I invested in her to know all the spells and scrolls and everything. I was being a good friend to her. And then because of that bloody Corgan, who was pushing it. I admit it, he was pushing it.
Your day's up and I'm still here.
Take the hint and head back to your little circus, girly. But come on. She just woke up in the morning in the middle of the maze, in the middle of Bodhi's maze, and said, "No, this is too much for me, I'm leaving." And she went back to the circus. How will she survive? Now I'm thinking, was she plotting with Irenicus as well? Because how can a lady so fragile survive that bloody maze that five of us hardly could? I'm hurt. I'm very hurt. I am hurt. I am really hurt by this game. All right, then we got out. We got out of the maze. We survived. We did everything. It was fine. Yes, yes, we looted a little bit. We got some nice items. Everything was fine. We got out. We've gathered an army and we went towards Irenicus, dealing this once and for all. Guess what? Like Bodhi, for the second time already before, also Irenicus left when he was about to be dead. What a coward! Only cowards do that. Bodhi and him are both big cowards who are like very egocentric and behaving like little children. Like me now, for instance. But I will rant some more because then, guess who showed up for party? It was again Yoshima. And again, stupid Lost. I was like, now he's gonna apologize and say, all right, let's do this. I wanna be back. I am so, so sorry. Help me get out through this. Or no, I know I will die if I turn my back on Irenicus, but I wanna do it. I wanna die with honor. I wanna be honorable. I wanna do something good in life. No. No, he decided to fight me till the end, till the very last breath. What a bloody asshole. I thought the time together meant something. It did not. So I killed him and his murderers and everything. And I swear, when I find Irenicus and when I find Bodhi once and for all, I will deal with them. I swear. And I'm not changing anyone in my party anymore. No, I'm keeping Corgi. I like him very much. He's annoying. He wants to see my guts open, how they look like and stuff like that. But he's just saying that. He doesn't mean it. He's mean perhaps, but if you tickle him under his beard, he's fine. So, Corgi, he's my tank. Mezzi, although she's a bit uptight and maybe she looks down upon people, like she's way too sophisticated for everyone, but she's fine and they flirt kind of with Corgan. I'm also keeping later on Vicky. I have a feeling she'll never leave me. So I kind of bet my money on her that she'll stay with me till the very end. There's me and then there's Imuen. We're only five of us now. Because we've been double crossed. But no matter what, I will fight till the end. I'll get to the bottom of this. I will survive. No matter what, even if I'm turning into a monster now, now that my soul of Baal or whatever is gone, I've been robbed of my soul. Irenicus, whom else? And Imuen, by the way, Imuen has been robbed of her soul by freaking bloody Bodhi, but we'll get it back. I'll do everything I can and I'll cut through this. Now, they really got me started. So there, I had to blow off some steam. I did it and I will continue playing Baldur's Gate 2, Shadows of Un. And I'll see where the path leads me and I am determined to finish it morally, more or less, you know, neutral good and stuff. And I don't know, get richer, get better, do some more magic, finally fight a leech or two, maybe Faircrag. I saved him for later. And then we'll see. So take care, have fun, and either see you on Twitch or see you here. Till next time, lovely people.